We now move on to bout number 5 of the show. So please welcome into the blue corner from Spain, Victor Martin. Victor And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the red corner from Titans Gym, Kieran Peart. This bout is scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds and will be contested under full Muay Thai rules in the 72.5 kilogram division. Over to your referee.
Combat Fight Series live from Fairfield Halls. We've got this one is not Dominic James versus Silvano. Dominic James ended that one with a beautiful head kick, but now we move to A-class Muay Thai. Victor Martin against Kieran Peart, 72.5 kgs, and Peart looks massive at the weight. Victor Martin, very experienced, over 50 bouts. Peart, 7-1-1, still making his way in this game, but he is an A-class Muay Thai fighter at a Titans gym. 5 3-minute rounds for these two to work their way in and really put on a show here in Croydon. So Victor Martin of Spain in the blue gloves, black and orange trunks with silver trim. Kieran Peart of Titans, white trunks, red gloves.
And importantly, the first of the A-class boats this evening, so knees and elbows are allowed to the head. Nice measured start from both gentlemen. Solid low kick there from Peart.
Yeah, a little difference in technique as well. You see Victor Martin stands there. He's got those elbows wide and high. You've got Peart with those palms turned out, but the elbows closer in, just protecting the rib cage a bit more.
Looks very big at the weight.
Yeah, huge. I couldn't believe he was 72.5 kgs, to be honest.
Nice little turn in the clinch from Kieran. Victor just kicking the leg there when Peart already had his block up, so I don't know what result he was expecting there.
Oh, nice jab there from Peart. And then just swats away the response from Martin.
Yeah, he sits with his range nicely there, just using that teep to the leg to dictate the pace. Jumping elbow down onto the top of the head.
And a kick across the ribs from Victor Martin.
He's not really got the sting in his kicks though, has he, Martin? Whereas Peart's leg kick looks like it's having effect already.
And right on cue, as soon as you've said that, he nearly kicks the legs from under Martin.
The lead leg of Martin is very red so far.
Oh, heavy right hands from Peart.
Only so many of those leg kicks you can take as he eats another one right on cue. Nice knees. Good hand in the face from Martin there, using that to open up the stomach for his left knee. He's let it go now. Don't know why he gave that position up. He had a nice dominant position there.
Goes for the inside of the right knee this time. Does Peart.
Body kick from Martin.
Yeah, just interesting. Victor Martin actually limped back to his corner there. That left leg has taken some punishment.
Yeah, I was just watching that. His left leg has taken a lot of damage, and this early in the fight is extremely dangerous. You can't come back from that. That's the problem. You can't shake it off. It doesn't go away. It's annoying.
Well, do you know what? That was one of the shots there that did it. Just the right kick straight across the left leg up top. Just on that thigh. What's the correct thing to do there? Because he stood there still at the moment, and I'd be thinking the leg would seize up. Would you keep it moving, or would you just rest it?
I'd probably stay on my feet like that. I wouldn't want to sit down. You sit down and it tends to make it worse, but I would try and move around a little bit.
That's something that happens to me with age, though, Dave. I can't get up off the sofa without making noises these days without seizing up.
No comment.
Round two, though, and Victor Martin does limp to the middle. He has taken some punishment there. Kieran Peart does some good work, a little touch of the gloves, and a couple of jabs to start with from Peart, straight through the guard, and then tries to get those knees away in the clinch.
And Martin dangerously puts one leg in the middle when he clinches up. That's better now. Locking the body strong. Needs the knee from there, or the referee's going to break him. Needs to work the knees. That's better work for Martin now. Tying up the arms. Remember, we are allowed elbows in this one. As the referee stops for a cuddle. The referee just grabbing them so they don't go out the ropes. Referee saying you need to work. As Martin locks up and nullifies his opponent, throws that left elbow.
Not sure it's caught as clean as he'd have liked, but the first time we've seen it in close.
It's a bit of a forearm slam. He didn't really flick the actual point of the elbow out. That's better knees from Peart there. Knee in that leg, but not really scoring. It's just more to do more damage to the where he's kicked already. You can see there is a lot of damage done on that lead leg of Martin.
Nice knees there in the clinch from Peart, but as a contest from Martin's perspective, it's much better in the clinch than it was when they were stood at range.
Certainly. If I was blue corner, I think I'd be saying take it to the clinch and just start to work a bit better.
That
on the outside, he's getting smashed.
Yeah, that kick to the ribs hurt. You can see it in his face.
That's better. Better work from Martin there. Locking strongly. He needs the knee. Turn from Peart and knees back.
Has his gloves taken off the ropes by the referee.
There you go. Hand in the face by Peart. Pushing his man down. Lining up for the elbow, but Martin escapes and scores a good knee of his own. Locking up, trying to nullify Peart's work. Does well to do so.
Final minute of round number two. Better round for Martin. It's been a good round from Peart.
Certainly is. And this is, as you identified, this is a much better place for him to be. On the outside was not great. But Peart, so physically strong. Almost looks like he's a weight group above, doesn't he?
Yeah. Huge of the weight, because to be fair, Martin looks in great shape at the weight himself, but
looks like one of those who just walks around at the fight weight, whereas Peart has probably dropped from about 85 kilos or something.
Oh, the elbow's coming in from Martin. Looking at lead with that elbow, almost in behind his head as he came in.
Yeah, I thought there'd be a spinning right elbow there, off the back of it, but he missed the opportunity. Much better round there from the Spaniard. Just heading into that replay now. Great body kick from Red. Much better work in the clinch and a much better round from blue corner number two, because round one was all red for me.
Here we go, round three. Both men have had two rounds to feel each other out. Victor Martin has found a way that he can get back into this fight. What's Kieran Peart got in response? Remember, Martin, the travelling fighter, but with much more experience.
Yeah, this is also within Muay Thai scoring. Round three is where things step up.
Yeah.
And they step up big. And there's that right elbow from Martin again.
Yeah, he was short with it. It bounced off the gloves, but it's intent, isn't it?
As we know from doing a few of these together, Dave, it's one shot can end a fight.
Oh, lovely elbow there in short. Oof. Again. It wasn't right on the point. It was more with the forearm, but
I like what Martin's doing there, covering the mouth and nose and pushing the head away. One, you push them off balance, and where the head goes, the body follows. And two, you're covering their mouth and nose. It's hard to breathe. Nice lock up there from the Spaniard. Spinning elbow attempt. Narrowly missing. Much better work here.
He looks
from Martin.
Fighter.
Yep. It's almost like he needed that little kickabout in the first round to wake up.
Well, Peart with some good heavy knees in the clinch here. And again, bit of space for him to work with Peart. Oh, three.
Ooh,
or
these
four
are showstoppers.
Fabulous knees. And then the spinning punch from Martin on the way out.
I don't know why he stopped though. He really had him where he wanted him. Those knees from Peart were strong.
Oh, just imagine the weight of the knees. Got legs like tree trunks as well, straight up the ribcage.
Right elbow coming in there from Martin.
Again, good knees. Oh,
That lock up from Martin there.
Yeah, managing to nullify.
So he scores on that. Showing that you can stop your opponent from working. Pierre working back on the outside.
Sway backwards there from Pierre to miss the kick.
I don't know why he stopped kicking the leg though, do you? Such good effect at the start, and he seems to have just stopped it. Nice lock up by Martin again. He holds it long enough, the referee will break him, but...
If anything, obviously it's an attacking move, that leg kick, but it's going to stop Martin coming forward.
Yeah.
And he's just looking to walk forward, get into that clinch.
Nice. Nice knee there. See Martin using his head in the clinch there as well, gaining position. This is where you'd expect him, jab low kick from Pierre. Smash that leg as Martin walks in.
Yeah, little left elbow through the middle there from Martin, but Peart again trying to get those knees away, trying to be busier in the clinch. Did have that period in the middle of the third round with what you described as showstoppers. Two, three, four really clean knees to the ribcage. Martin is tired. He is hunched over the ropes there with both hands over them, but still this fight a lot closer than it could have been after round one.
Yeah, I feel like Kieran Peart's making this fight harder than he needs to. I feel like he could stop Martin if he just kept it simple, straight punches and low kicks. I hate to say it because I'm a big fan of the Muay Thai style and the clinch work, but it's not the way to win this fight for Kieran Peart. As you look here in the clinch, almost eats a head kick there. Again, Martin locking his man up. Does really well to do so too. As we head into round four. Big money round. How much gas is in the tank, Victor Martin? That's the question.
Well, Peart needs to go back to basics, doesn't he? If he keeps this fight at range, he wins the fight.
Jab, low kick on the end of that jab.
Oh, big flying knee from Kieran Peart.
That was a beauty. Martin is a beast. How is he still standing after that?
Oh, he's a bit giddy, isn't he, as he stumbles up. But God, what a chin.
Peart landing that stiff jab and just needs to pop the low kick on the end of it.
He looks pretty relaxed out there when it's at range, Kieran Peart. Looking at the eyes there. Oh, there's
there
the
go.
Kick. That's the one.
Back to it. Chop the leg there.
Flying knee was a beauty.
That was lovely. I'm all for doing fancy moves, but for me, get the basics right. Fundamentals win fights. He could make this fight a lot easier for himself. This area is dangerous for Kieran Peart. Victor Martin is always a danger in the clinch. And if you allow him to come close, you could put yourself in a vulnerable position.
With a heavy knee through the middle there from Peart. Oh, good jab. And all of a sudden, Martin wobbled there.
Yeah, Martin's, but that's fatigue, I think. I think Martin is literally blown his load doing that.
But again, he's got that hand across the face. He's smart in the clinch, isn't he, Victor Martin?
Yeah, that's the experience showing through, I think. Controlling the arms there as well. Looking to line up the elbows. See that pushing the face off to the side, covering the mouth and nose. Great work from Victor Martin there in the clinch. And look how tired he is.
Still a minute of this round to go and another 3 minutes afterwards. Good kick, low kick there from Martin.
Don't tell him that. Nice knee from Kieran. Look how thick his back is.
Yeah.
It's massive. Where's the kicks? Where's the body kicks there, Kieran?
Lovely movement there from Kieran Peart, but
but no counter. Where's the counter there? Made a miss, didn't counter.
Well, I'm wondering. Oh, spinning elbow from Martin. I'm just wondering how fatigued Peart might be, because it's obvious to us that Martin is tired. If he jumps on it, if he keeps him at range, if he puts him where he wants him, he wins this fight. But he's making it difficult for himself. Is that because he is more tired than he's letting on?
Potentially. But I don't know, looking at the two of them, I'd say Martin's more tired out of the two. He's just picking where he works better. If you watch the replays, well, I don't know what that is. Here we go. Got one more round here. Oh, there was that jumping knee. Jeez, man, I don't know how he stood up after that. Fair play to him. Victor Martin is made of tough stuff.
Fifth and final round then. High stakes here. A big round for either man. Could be enough. Victor Martin raises his hands to the sky here in Croydon. He thinks he's in this fight and he could be right. Nice teep to start the round there though for Kieran Peart.
To be fair, Martin has grown throughout this fight. He's saying about the leg kick, but I wouldn't chance it, mate.
Oh no.
You can see your leg smashed. Often when people signal to it and say, yeah, come on in, it's normally because it hurt them.
Oh,
that
nice
was nice work.
Really nice.
Kieran needs to put his right hand in the face of Martin. He uses his head nicely. But no score, he needs to knee more. Where's the body kicking from Kieran Peart?
Both exchange jabs there, and good connection from Martin. Maybe he won that jab exchange. Good couple of shots, but they just bounce off the gloves and arms of Kieran Peart.
Takes the back nicely, goes for a knee to the head.
Lands a knee.
And again.
Yeah, Martin does not want to leave his head there.
No, Martin needs to lock the body up like he's just done. Hold him tight, hand in the face, there you go. Elbow, knee, good work from the Spaniard. Peart comes back against the ropes. Just not working enough for me. I'd like to see Red Corner work more. It's almost like he looks to line something up and just never does it. I can see he's got skills, it's just frustrating to watch. He should be kicking the body now, kick his body. Instead he just keeps the leg and just doesn't really score.
But at this stage in his career, what are we, 9-10 fights in, this is a great learning fight for him against a guy who's been in there 50 times.
But I feel like he does need to learn from this fight. He needs to look at it and see just where he made this a lot harder than it needed to be. He's moaning about stuff there, which says you're uncomfortable, you're tired. Hopefully he'll take this as constructive criticism. Maybe he'd have just sat back, used that jab low kick, jab body kick. Had great effect with a low kick, could have probably stopped him. And then he's just neglected to score. For me, he's been dominant on the outside, yet just wasted those opportunities in the latter stages of this fight. I feel like Martin wants it more now. He's knackered, he's blowing, he's coming forward, knees, elbows.
I mean, credit to Martin, his engine's unbelievable because he's been empty since the end of round two.
Yeah, that is true.
But here he is, less than 20 seconds to go.
Knee to the back from Martin. Locks up again. Stops the man in the red gloves working. Right, goes for that teep to the leg again, doing nothing. It's really frustrating to watch. He's better than that.
5 rounds completed. Kieran Peart started the stronger, but Martin grew into the fight. We go to the judges' scorecards, and this one very much in the balance.
as we go to our MC for the official results.
Relentless intent from him as both men pay their respects in the ring.
I have to say, massive respect to Victor Martin there. He did exactly what he had to do. He took the fight into the dimension that was best for him in the clinch, and he worked it well. I hope Kieran Peart uses this as a learning experience, because I almost feel like he lost that fight rather than Victor Martin won it.